I'm here with Wolfgang Vogl from Austria, and Wolfgang introduced a product, Waveex, to me about a year ago. It's a small chip that makes a big difference, and I was very interested in the technology and also very skeptical, thinking, is this another gimmick? Because it's supposed to go on the back of a cell phone and reduce the exposure of electromagnetic radiation. And I didn't really understand how is this all possible. So I visited you in Austria and I spent some time with your team to really understand how this little chip can make a difference to a cell phone user. Can you please tell our readers in little short context, how does this work? How is it possible for a sticker on the back of your phone to reduce your exposure to the harmful effects of electromagnetic radiation?
Mm-hmm. Okay. The problem we are dealing with is that everybody is only thinking to high frequency radiation. But since the second generation of mobile communication, GSM protocol, there's also now extreme low frequency radiation coming from the mobile phone. So what we did in here, we did not focus to the high frequency. Instead, we are focusing to the extreme low frequency magnetic fields. And here we are looking to the gradients. That means gradients are irritations in the magnetic field. That means here it is more intensive than here and here less than here. And these tiny gradients irritate the magnetite crystals inside our brain. This had been discovered in 1992 by the California Institute of Technology, Caltech, Dr. Kirschwink. And he found out once this magnetite crystal in the brain are irritated, a certain kind of hormone and protein synthesis does not work proper anymore. This leads to that the protective shield around the DNA, surrounding the DNA, breaks down, and now the high frequency has the ability to damage the DNA. The effect is that the stress level of the body is increased. So we can prove for 100% sure that we take away the gradients, the whole process is working again. Melatonin is setting up the protective shield around the DNA again, and the stress level in the body is lowered. So we can measure this with an ECG equipment, measuring the heartbeat ratio. There we have the according certificates also.
And you also do live blood analysis?
For sure, we also do the blood analysis. The one thing is that from the, let's say, old-fashioned medical doctors, this is not accepted, but for sure, the let's say, doctors thinking in the new way, they absolutely appreciate the test. And just right now, there's also a pilot study where it is shown that there is no more damage done to the DNA by Waveex. But more I cannot tell just right now because the study is still ongoing, so I don't want to take away all the results before it is really published.
Are you in any way able to give us a little hint of what was used during this experiment?
This experiment already had been done once in 2014. They checked eggs of chicken eggs when they were hatched, and during the hatching process. And back then they found out there's a big difference between the control group and the eggs which had been radiated, with damage done to the DNA, free radicals, oxidative stress, and all of that kind.
So they placed a mobile phone, an active mobile phone over those eggs.
Yeah, absolutely. And now this team did the test again, but now a third group with Waveex. And we are so proud to tell that for sure without Waveex the same dramatic effects are shown. But now with Waveex we are absolutely at the control group. But this will be out in about, let's say, 3 to 4 weeks.
Wonderful. And it will be published in medical
journals? For sure. It will be peer-reviewed in scientific journals. And yeah, I'm very happy because this is a well-known team of science. So they are accepted. And therefore, yeah, it's a big credibility.
So you're talking about a little chip with technology, yeah. 7 layers of technology inside it.
Yeah.
That works with either electrical circuit or magnetic field.
We are focusing here mainly on the magnetic field.
Right.
Because to every electric frequency, there's always a married magnetic field.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore I told you this magnetic field gradients.
Mm-hmm.
So because now we have one solution for all the frequencies. So we do not care if there's a new frequency showing up in the radio frequency area, it will still work the same. So we do not have to exchange the programming of Waveex.
So this is not a chip that you can wear as a beautiful piece of jewelry. This actually has to go onto a battery or power source or transformer.
We have to go as close as possible to the power source. In the case of a mobile phone, to the battery. In the case of a Wi-Fi router, to the power switch. That means where the 220 volt come in and are converted to this 5 or 7 or 12 voltage.
So DC. The AC-DC plug?
Yeah, the AC-DC plug, yes. As close as possible to the DC output.
Mm-hmm. And if you want to put it on your laptop, you also need to find the battery?
Yes, you have to find the battery, also on all the tablets and all of that stuff. That means as soon as you can access the DC part of the unit, you are happy, and for sure the unit should have a broadcasting functionality, otherwise it makes no sense.
So where the DC part is sitting, you know, normally when electricity and the magnetic field meet, you have all the chaos, right?
Yeah.
With the electrons running around all over the place.
Yeah.
So this calms down that chaos. And smooths out the gradient.
Yeah. We got here, once we got the call from an engineer from Orange, from Shanghai, and he told us about that he found out that with Waveex, the life of the battery is a little longer than usual. Also, the numbers are being recharged, they could increase it. But to be honest, just right now, we did not have studies in there. But when a guy from Orange calls us claiming about that, okay, we are happy about that.
Mm. Do you have any other products in the developing line?
Yes, we are now also looking for a product you can put on the AC also, because then we also could equip, for instance, TV sets with Waveex, because here we have the problem we cannot access the DC part, that's somewhere in there. Mm-hmm. Also then for pointers and so on. And what we already have in our labs ready is Waveex for antenna towers, but yeah, we are not access to any to
that's,
access
that's
any
very
antenna
difficult
tower.
To get hold of someone that allow you to go and test Waveex at an antenna tower.
Yeah. But it makes sense for sure. You first have to do studies with the people living there, doing the medical tests before, and then afterwards that you can be 100% sure that it really works.
And earphones and smartwatches?
Earphones, my personal opinion concerning earphones is everybody recommends wearing earphones. But as long as the cable is not shielded, you are doing a bad thing, because then you lead all the information directly into your ear. But there, I've seen now this AirTube earphones. Also the like FBI and so on, they all use it already. So you have here an tube, air tube,
mm-hmm.
and the converter is down here. So the magnetic field is far away from your head and no electric field at all, because you only have the air pipes in here.
Okay.
So that would be best.
And you still put a Waveex on the battery unit?
For sure. On the power unit in this case is the mobile phone.
Mm-hmm.
So you already have Waveex on the mobile phone, so this is also safe.
Mm-hmm. What about your competition products? People that are claiming that their product bring down the SAR value. I know it's quite a spot for you, so I have to ask you this question.
Yeah. This typical SAR value, it's the specific absorption rate. That means how much energy is absorbed from our body when making a phone call. And there is a definition of a maximum value by the governments. But this maximum value only protects against the thermic effect to our body, not at all against the biological effects. And what happens in here, it does not said in the biological effects, you cannot see in that way, the higher the worse. No, there are some biological windows, and they can be anywhere, different with every frequency and secondary modulation. Therefore, it makes no sense to claim to bring down that SAR value, to reduce this value, because you never ever know what happens then. You can reduce it and then be inside a biological window and hurt your body more than before. So it's the wrong approach.
And you also once said to me, if you have a nice big laptop with two batteries,
yeah,
you don't put a Waveex on each battery because they'll conflict?
I would advise only putting one in there, because we did measurements at home that showed when you put two Waveex in there, they're a little bit conflicting. Mm. So there can only be one master. Mm. If there are two masters, they will quarrel about. So only put one.
How long does it last?
The warranty is 2 years, but the oldest Waveex now is 6 years, and it still works like at the first day, so no loss of power. So we can give the guarantee for sure for the 2 years, but if you put it to a Wi-Fi router, it will last at least for the 6 years.
I've done my own testing, I've told you about it.
Yeah.
We use the Ryanex machine. Obviously experimental testing,
yeah,
you know, using a phone for a while with Waveex and using it without Waveex and experiencing the difference in stress levels.
Yeah.
So I'm really, really wishing you all the best with the development of the product and the sales, and I hope you will be received,
yeah,
globally and recognized for this incredible work.
Thank you so much.
We all need this technology.
Thank you so much. Okay.